Hello and welcome to the show. Join me in the next 30 minutes as we meet the world's greatest Western photographer, David Steckelin. You know, every year we've got to take pictures and update the profiles and stuff for television and for the website and all that. And David always comes down to the ranch and I don't know if he gets better every year. I just seem to appreciate his work a lot more. But every time he leaves, we're so excited about the content that we've gotten from him and he's just unbelievable.
Well, we're going to go, they're bringing in the horses, and Chris has come over here today to kind of help out Thomas with a bunch of work. They got cattle to move and horses to move, and so it's just a great opportunity for me to get some pictures of some of my favorite guys, Thomas Saunders and Chris Cox. It's awesome that these guys have become friends, because of course I've known them in different worlds, both of them, and now they're real good buddies, and they live down here in Texas, and I love it. I've been working on this ranch for 22 years.
Where do you want me, Steckelin?
Just make sure you're right with the horses and not alone. That's the cool thing about down here. You can always get the authentic part of the real West. You know, this isn't any phony stuff. This is the real stuff that we're trying to preserve on film. You know, the West is fading, and I've been trying to capture it and preserve it for the last 30 years. Just drive through those trees. Let's go over here. Bring the horses like up there. Drive them along. See where that patch of red is? You'll be good there. I got you. Go.
I'm being interviewed over here.
You know, the sun, there it goes. See, we lost our light. These guys are all down there messing around. You know, the worst time I ever saw the light, I was working with Robert Redford and Brad Pitt. We were down on the river for River Runs Through It, and it was a beautiful sunrise, and just waiting and waiting and waiting for Brad Pitt to get ready, and down there with Redford and everybody, and finally they had to bring out all the lights because Brad Pitt took so long to get his pretty on. It was amazing. But we're going to have great light here. It's only going to get better. You know, in the afternoon, the light's coming right at you, the good light. That's the best time to take pictures. In the morning, it's running away from you, you know. You just, hard to get good morning pictures. Chris, hold up so the horses are right with you. Hey, bring them back. You guys are just on this side of these trees. Slow down, Chris. Slow down, let them catch you. Thomas, when you bring them back through, get enough time to get a little speed and have Chris come where you came, right here with me. And the horse is just on the other side, but when they're looking too docile. These are all people that multitask, if you notice these cowboys. He's We're doing this beautiful photo shoot, and he's organizing and thinking about the next photo shoot. And some of these guys aren't dressed the way they want, and he wants the right bit in the horse and everything. Now, these guys, Thomas has been in my pictures for, I think, 23 years now. So he's an expert photo model and producer and director. These two guys are such characters, both of them. Well, the two, in their individual ways, are probably the best cowboys I know anywhere in the world. You know, Chris is considered one of the best horse trainers in the world, but Chris knows cattle. He grew up on a cattle ranch, and he knows cattle. Of course, Thomas has spent his whole life with cattle and horses, and he bucks a lot of horses and trains a lot of horses and also cattle. So these guys are good. They've been in front of a camera a lot. They know what looks good in front of a camera. So this is a real treat for me. And as I said earlier, it's a treat for me to have my friends together doing the same thing. So anyways, it's just beautiful. I mean, you couldn't have a better day with blue sky and clouds, green grass, green trees, flowers everywhere, and some great horses and great cowboys. Well, horses, they have a tolerance level where they'll let you mess with them so many times, and after a while they get bored with it all, so they gotta kinda move on. So you gotta kinda, when you're doing a photo shoot, first you gotta have guys that can really, really handle livestock. And then the second thing is you gotta have enough livestock because you burn them out. It's like working with children. They just, their sensitivities, their attention span is so short. Oh yeah, just beautiful. Photography in the last 5 years has taken a quantum leap. And the quantum leap is digital, and the way that the cards process the images, and the way that then the computers store them, and the way you can process the pictures and develop the pictures in your computer system, it's just unbelievable. And I've been with Canon cameras now for probably 18 years. I'm a member of this Canon. Best I can say, it's a club of supposedly the best photographers in the world. It's called the Canon Explorers of Light, and there's about 50 guys. And we all use Canon gear, and it literally is the best camera equipment in the world. And every year, it seems like they come out with something new. And it's not just a gadget, it's something that really improves the quality of the photograph. And for me, you know, I was the last guy to switch from film, so it's been the last 4 years have been the most dramatic switch for me. And really the last 2 years has been the most quantum leap in my knowledge of how to operate my computers, how to operate my cameras, so that I can get the most out of what I'm doing.
Ready? Let's go, go!
Chris, just mill around in there with them. Get them dusty, get the dust up. Make them run.
What am I doing here? You want me to rope one?
Just go this way, not yet. When I get it really dusty, you're gonna rope one right in front of me. There you go, look at your horses, get ready. Okay, now, get them moving a little faster. I'm gonna have Chris rope one. Hey Chris, pick one out as it comes by. Throw the rope right at me.
I'll just rope him in a group here. Good.
When I say rope, you halt right there so you don't get in the background. Okay, but you make a move fast for Chris. Let's get him dusty and dirty.
Let me know when you want me to rope.
I'll yell rope. You move this way a little bit. See, I'm just trying to keep the barn on the background. Good, good, good. Make him go! Go! Go!
The one thing about David Steckline is I've gotten to know him over the last 10 years or so, and he just amazes me that he can put himself in a position that most photographers wouldn't even get in. He has the knowledge to be able to get around a horse or around a cow, and he looks like it's pretty dangerous, and he does some things that are crazy sometimes, but he'll come up with the best shots.
Don't get kicked in the head. We want to see some ranch rodeo. Yeah, come on, up him. Get up him, Slick. Get up him, Slick. Get up him, Slick. Don't let him put it over you, Slick. Do it Alabama style.
Oh, Steckline, he's just right in the middle of it, ain't he?
Watch out, David.
Yeah, I didn't weaken.
You didn't. I was proud of you. You know, the only thing I'm a little bit puzzled about, this big tough guy gets around all these animals and up underneath their stomachs taking pictures in front of a stampede of horses, and he's so worried about these little bugs called chiggers. I don't understand that.
So there any chiggers in this grass? Any snakes out here? You sure there's no chiggers? Now, you know I'm really scared of chiggers. I'm just looking for snakes. This is awesome. Hey, there ain't no chiggers or snakes in here, are there? Oh my God, I hate those things. You don't have those in Australia, do you?